गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रोफेसर पलाश जैन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट SIRT भोपाल. टुडे विल टीच यू द सेकेंड टॉपिक ऑफ आवर सब्जेक्ट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्ड थ्योरी, दैट इज द सिलेंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम. एज यू ऑल आर अवेयर दैट इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टडीड द कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम एंड लर्न अबाउट द थ्री पैरामीटर्स, दैट इज द एक्स, वाई and z axis, their range, their differential length, differential surface and differential volume. We have seen a detailed description of the Cartesian coordinate system in the previous session, and in today's session we will study the cylindrical coordinate system, that is our the second type of coordinate system, that is the cylindrical coordinate system. Now first the question arises that why we are studying the cylindrical coordinate system. So or I can say that what is the need of cylindrical coordinate system? Is the Cartesian coordinate system is not enough sufficient to describe the mathematics or physics or of our subject electromagnetic field theory? So the basic need of cylindrical coordinate system is, in physics you have learned many things and you have studied many things regarding electric field intensity, magnetic field intensity, where you have find out the various parameters of electric and magnetic field across the cylindrical surfaces. For example, I can say that the infinitely line charge, okay. So these comes in the category of cylindrical coordinate system. So to study the infinite line charge or a finite line charge and these types of things, we need the cylindrical coordinate system. Or I can say that to find out the various parameters of electric field and magnetic field across these charges, yeah, I can say that line charges, we use the cylindrical coordinate system. Now if we talk about ki what is the real life example of a cylindrical coordinate system, so I can also give you the one example of the cylindrical coordinate system is, when you go on roads or walk on the roads, so you see the mobile towers. In mobile towers there are many antennas which are in the form of a cylindrical in shape. And now whenever you see that mobile towers, that's the shape of an antenna, you can see that the long bars, wide bars are connected across the mobile towers. So this also comes in the category of a cylindrical coordinate system. I can't say that these comes in the category, but you can easily understand that to study that types of antenna, we need the cylindrical coordinate system. Now the question arises that why I have you given the example of these types of antennas. So the basic thing is, I have given these type of examples is because the biggest application of electromagnetic field theory, we can say that is an antenna, and it is the real example which we daily use and daily see in our daily life. So to study the cylindrical coordinate system, first we will study the basic parameters of the cylindrical coordinate system. Now in the slide which is opening in front of you, you can see that I have drawn a basic cylinder over there. Theek? Now to the basic cylinder, you see that I have drawn across the x, y and z parameters. Now you can see that to analyze, yeah, to study this cylinder, I have taken three parameters. My first parameter is rho, which I have which is the distance measured from z axis. My second parameter is phi, which is the angle measured from x axis, okay, and my third parameter is z, which is the distance on the z axis. Now you don't have to learn these things. We will see every step by step and see how the cylinder we can draw on the coordinate system. So for drawing the cylinder, suppose you I have given you example. For example, for drawing the cylinder, the basic example of a cylinder is your water bottle. We can see that your water bottle is a nice example of a cylinder. Now what is a cylinder? A cylinder is generally made up of three surfaces, है ना. द फर्स्ट सर्फेस इज द टॉप मोस्ट सर्फेस विच वी कैन सी दैट दिस इज द सर्कल. द सेकेंड सर्फेस इज योर लैटरल सर्फेस दैट इज दिस कर्व्ड सर्फेस एंड द थर्ड सर्फेस इज योर अनदर सर्कल. एंड द मेन थिंग इज द एरिया ऑफ बोथ द सर्कल्स दिस फर्स्ट सर्कल एंड सेकेंड सर्कल इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम. Now to draw the cylinder on the coordinate axis, we will first suppose we will make an assumption that you are standing on the point somewhere in this point on the z-axis. Okay. Now to draw the cylinder, what you will do? We have to draw these three parts which I have told you here. This is the first part. This is the second part and this is the third part. This is first, this is second and this is third. Now how you will draw this cylinder? See, suppose you are standing at the center of a circle, that is somewhere at this point on the z-axis. Now how will you draw the circle? So to draw the circle we need radius. So to how you will make radius? So the thing is that suppose this is the z-axis. Okay, now to draw the circle you will take radius like this, rho. That is, you will move rho distance, you will move rho distance from the center, and now you will make a 360 degree turn like this. So in this way you have made the first surface. Okay, now the 360 degree round, which we can say that is a 0 to 2 pi round. Okay, now this is, we already know that this is our z axis. So how much distance we have moved from z axis to the outer part of the circle, that is the rho. And what I have written here is rho is the distance measured from z axis. So it is now clearly visible that rho is the distance measured from z axis. Now what is the phi? Phi is the angle measured from x axis in xy plane or azimuthal angle. Oh, okay. So now this is our x axis somewhere and this is our y axis. So this will be our xy plane. So phi, what is this? Phi is the angle measured from x axis in xy plane or azimuthal angle. So how much angle we have make? It is from 0 to 2 pi. So this is our phi angle. Now what is z? Z is the distance we have traveled on the z axis. Now we have made the upper circle. Now to cover the whole length we move, we come on this center part and we move to here on the center of the axis. Now here again we follow the same procedure and again we make the circle, and in this way our cylinder will make on the coordinate axis. So now you can clearly understand that how we have made the cylinder, and there are our three parameters rho, phi, z. So students, if you will study like this, so you will automatically you know the values of, or we can say that the range of the parameters. Now what is the range of the parameters? We can easily say that if we talk about the range of parameter, my first parameter is rho. Now one assumption you always say, always learn, that our surface is at infinite. What is surface? This is outermost surface which I am talking about. So our surface is always at infinite. Now if we talk about the range, the range is for rho. So for rho we start from here, from this point is at 0. Now many students say, sir, this is not at 0, this is on the z axis, so this will be at a some distance. No, this is not. We can say that this point, we also talk about this point, or we can also talk about the z point. So I am talking about the rho parameter. I am not talking about the z parameter. You are already correct that this point is at some distance from the origin. So this is the z axis point, not the rho point. So if we talk about rho, we are at 0. And how much distance we have moved from there? वी हैव मूव टिल सरफेस, है ना, दैट पॉइंट पी इज एट सरफेस. वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न दैट सरफेस इज एट इनफाइनाइट. तो वॉट विल बी द रेंज, रेंज ऑफ जी विल जी रो विल बी योर जीरो टू रो टू इनफाइनाइट. दैट इज वी मूव फ्रॉम जीरो टू सरफेस एंड सरफेस इज एट इनफाइनाइट. नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट आवर सेकेंड पैरामीटर, दैट इज phi. Now what is the range of phi? I have already told you that when we reach at point P, we make a circle of 360 degree. So circle will be from 0 to 2 pi and your phi will be 0 less than equal to phi less than 2 pi. Okay. Now our third parameter is z. You see here z. So z is what? The length of a cylinder. So there is upper surface, there is bottom surface, and surface is always at infinite. So our z parameter will be range from minus infinite to infinite, like this. That is minus infinite z infinite. So today we have learned the basic concept of cylindrical coordinate system, and we have learned the three parameters of the cylindrical coordinate system. In the next class, we will see the differential length, differential surface, and differential volume for cylindrical coordinate system. It is same as we have learned and studied in the Cartesian coordinate system. So, thank you for